فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. Last lesson we started a series where we called it معاملة حكام المسلمين في ضوء الكتاب والسنة. How we should deal with the Muslim leaders according to the Kitab and the Sunnah. We were speaking about that. And we gave a muqaddimah last lesson. Inshallah ta'ala, today we're going to go into, as we promised, each doubt and the response for it, inshallah ta'ala. And as we try, and as we said in the muqaddimah, in the introduction, that our responses are going to be concise. We're not going to go too much details. We could do, but that's not what the whole point of this series is. The whole point of this series is al-ijaz, a summarize and precise and to the point. So shubhatul ula, the first shubha, the first doubt that is brought, is ta'anuhum fi bay'ati al-hakim alladhi laysa min Quraysh. They criticize and they slander the pledge of allegiance that is given to the leader that's not from Quraysh. They say he's not from Quraysh. And since he's not from Quraysh, there's no pledge of allegiance on our side towards him. Na'am, we say that conditioning that he's from Quraysh is correct. We agree with you on that. That we need to look at when we're choosing the leader if he's from Quraysh, and that we choose him based on him being Quraysh. That's correct. But that is إِنَّمَا يُنظَرُ إِلَيْهِ فِي حَالِ الْإِخْتِيَارِ. We look at this when there is a choice on the table for us. When we have the ability to appoint him. And when we say we, I mean referring to if we are from the Ahlul Halli wal Aqd, the people who are in authority, who have the rights to elect and choose. If they are given that choice, and that it is halul ikhtiyar, the time when there is a choice, then they shouldn't choose anyone who's not from Quraysh. But if it's in a situation where غير قرشي, a person who's not from Quraysh, he takes over with power, he forces himself over the people, بِالْغَلَبَةِ وَالْقُوَّةِ, and he takes over. And then guess what? He then makes himself have strength over the people. فَلَا يَجُوزُ حِينَئِذٍ. At this particular point, it is not permissible, مُنَازَعَةٌ, to argue with him, or to go against him, or even to try to exchange him to the Qurashi leader, even if we can find the Qurashi leader. So what we said is, if there's halatul ikhtiyar, then ishtiratu kawnu al-hakim min Quraysh is sahih. Okay, it's correct. But if he comes with strength and power and force, and he uses military coup, comes into power, overcomes everybody, pushes himself forward, becomes the leader, and then when he does become leader, the country is in his hands. He's got strength over it. Okay? At this particular point, فَلَا تَجُوزُ حِينَئِذِ الْمُنَازَعَةُ. Trying to take him off it is not permissible. And going against him is not permissible. And you should not, and you're not allowed to try to exchange the Qurashi, even if you've got him. And inshallah ta'ala, we're going to bring نُقُولٌ عَلَى مَا نَقُولٌ. We're going to bring statements on what we are saying, and what the ulama said in this regard. First of all, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to bring the evidence to show that a leader has to be from Quraysh. Bayanu al-dalil, bringing forward the evidences, عَلَى اشْتِرَاطِ bringing the evidences in showing that the leader should be from Quraysh, is the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated in Hadith Abi Hurairah, Hadith of Hurairah, where the Prophet said, "An-nasu taba'un, an-nasu, the people are taba'un li Quraysh, that the people are followers of Quraysh, I mean they are under Quraysh, fi hadha shani, in this matter which is leadership." The Prophet said that. Also, the Prophet ﷺ said in a hadith, and another hadith, Ibn Umar narrated, Bukhari and Muslim, "La yazalu hadha al-amr, la yazalu hadha al-amri, this matter will always remain in fi Quraysh, it will remain with Quraysh, ma baqiya minhum ithnani, as long as two remain." In other words, this issue of leadership is in the hands of Quraysh. The Prophet said that, alayhi salatu wasalam, we are only open to hear and what? To submit. But what's funny is that many people don't know that when we say ghalaba and quwa, democratical election falls under ghalaba and quwa. Because anything that's not done through the Ahlul Halli wal Aqd, they didn't choose to elect this person, we will give it the ruling of what? As though it's what? Halatun al-dirar. We will say this situation is a situation that's been forced onto us. Are you with me? And it's ghalaba and quwa. Elections are ghalaba and quwa. So if he comes through election, the leader, are we all together? He hasn't come through the Shari way. And he comes into power. And he's not from Quraysh. We also, the same thing applies. We have to hear and we have to obey. I'm going to bring the statements of the ulama and what they said. If a person comes into power, he forces himself over the people and he's not from Quraysh, that we have to still listen to him. The consensus that scholars have brought. Ijma' is what? It's evidence. It's a hujjah, it's a proof. Look at what the ijma' is. Hafiz ibn Hajar said in Fath al-Bari, the 13th page, 9th volume, that the Prophet, he said, Qala ibn Battal, Ibn Battal is from the Shurrah of Bukhari. Hafiz ibn Hajar is bringing the statement of Ibn Battal. Ibn Battal said, Ajma' al-fuqaha'u, the jurists have unanimously agreed, Ala wujubi ta'ati sultanil mutaghallib, that it's obligatory to obey the leader that has come into place with force. Wal jihadi ma'ahu, and that you have to do jihad with that leader. Meaning he's still your leader. Wa anna ta'atahu khayrun, and obeying him is better, min al khuruj alayhi, to go against him. Who said this? Ibn Hajar transmits it from Ibn Battal. And he brought what? Ijma', there's no khilaf on this issue. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, in his kitab Ad-Durrassaniyah, he brought ijma' in this issue as well. He says, Al-A'immatu mujmi'una, that the imams, scholars, are unanimously in agreement. Min kulli madhabin, from every madhab. So it's a Hanafi believe this, Malikiya believe this, Shafi'iyya believe this, Hanabila believe this. Every madhab believes this. There's no difference of opinion. Ala anna man taghallaba. Ala anna man taghallaba. That whoever comes in play with, he comes into power with force, ala baladin aw buldan, whoever comes in force in one country or two countries, or it doesn't matter, lahu hukmul imami, he is given the ruling of an imam, fi jami'il ashiya', in all matters. Intaha kalam. The third person who brought an ijma', a consensus, is Allama Abdul Latif, who is the son of AbdulRahman ibn Hassan, who is the son of who? Muhammad ibn عبد الوهاب. In مجموع الرسائل والمسائل النجدية, third volume, page 168, he says, وأهل العلم, the people of knowledge, are متفقون, the people of knowledge are all in agreement, على طاعتي, that we have to obey, من تغلب عليهم في المعروف, whoever takes over them, they have to obey him في المعروف, in good. If he tells us to do something haram, we won't listen to him. But if he commands us to do good, we will listen to him. We won't say, how dare you tell us good? You came into power with unjustly. We don't say that, we listen. يَرَوْنَ نُفُوذَ أَحْكَامِ وَصِحَّةِ إِمَامَتِهِ. The scholars, they all see that his ahkam as a ruler is executed. And the authenticity of his leadership. لَا يَخْتَلِفُ فِي ذَلِكَ اثْنَانِ. Two do not differ on this issue. Who's saying this? Abdul Latif. So we have to accept that. And don't, brothers and sisters, don't be shocked with these ijma'at that I just brought. وَلَا تَسْتَغْرِبْ هَذِهِ الْإِجْمَعَاتِ فَقَدْ أَشَارَ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إِلَى وِلَايَةِ غَيْرُ الْقُرَيْشِ. The Prophet pointed out that there are leaders who are going to be that are not Quraysh, and he told us to listen and obey them. The Prophet said in the hadith of Abu Dharr, Abu Dharr رضي الله تعالى عنه, the Prophet said, أوصاني خليلي, that my loved one, meaning the Prophet, he advised me, أن أسمع وأطيع, that I listen and I obey, وإن كان عبدا مجدع الأطراف. Even if the person in charge is a slave and his limbs are cut, he's disabled. Somebody, no one would give any value to him. But he comes into power that I listen and I obey him, even if he's what? Deficient, disabled. Also another hadith of Prophet ﷺ, he said, in the hadith of Umm al-Husayn, he said, إِنْ أُمِّرَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَبْدٌ مُجَدَّعَ. If a leader is placed over you, forcefully placed over you, and he's a slave, mujadda, limbs are gone, mutated, he's got no arms or fingers or missing from him. يَقُودُكُمْ بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ, he's judging you by the book of Allah. فَاسْمَعُوا وَأَطِيعُوا, listen and obey him. He's not Quraysh. He came into power unjustly. He's wrong. He doesn't even meet the criteria that was set. But the Prophet said, listen and obey. And Imam al-Nawawi said, under the explanation of that hadith, he says, وَتُتَصَوَّرُ إِمَامَةُ الْعَبْدِ إِذَا وَاللَّهُ بَعْضُ الْأَئِمَّةِ أَوْ تَغَلَّبَ عَلَى الْبِلَادِ بِشَوْكَتِهِ وَأَتْبَاعِهِ وَلَا يَجُوزُ ابْتِدَاءً عَقْدَ الْوِلَايَةِ لَهُ مَعَ الْإِخْتِيَارِ بَلْ شَرْطُهَا الْحُرِّيَّةِ. So Imam al-Nawawi, sorry, he's saying to you, it can be perceived. The imamah of a slave, if, meaning it's possible, it can happen, it's something that can occur. The leadership of a slave, if other leaders have put him in place. So other leaders are his friends, they leave, they push him in. Or, تَغَلَّبَ عَلَى الْبِلَادِ بِشَوْكَتِهِ وَأَتْبَاعِهِ. He has his followers, he has his strength and his power and his army, he comes into the country, and he takes over everything. It can also happen in that way. Then he goes on to say, وَلَا يَجُوزُ ابْتِدَاءً عَقْدَ الْوِلَايَةِ. But if it's on our side, we can't initiate leadership for him مَعَ الْإِخْتِيَارِ, if we have the choice. بَلْ شَرْطُهَا الْحُرِّيَّةِ. Because the condition of leadership is that the person is free, can't be a slave. Are we all together? It's that the person is what? Is free. That kalam of Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala also explains it. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah in his Sharh Riyad al-Salihin, he says, when he explains the hadith of أُوصِيكُمْ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ وَالسَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَةِ وَإِنْ تَأَمَّرَ عَبْدٌ حَبَشِي, he says, ibn Uthaymeen, السَّمْعُ وَالطَّاعَةِ, listen and obey, يَعْنِي لِوَلِيِّ الْأَمْرِ, listen and obey to the leader. وَإِنْ تَأَمَّرَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَبْدٌ حَبَشِي, if a Abyssinian slave governs you, سَوَاءً كَانَتْ إِمْرَتُهُ عَامَّ, it doesn't matter whether his leadership is general, like he's a, for instance, كَالرَّئِيسِ الْأَعْلَى, he's like the actual president of the country, أو خَاصَ, or whether he's just a governor, he's just a what? كَأَمِيرِ بَلْدَةً, he's just a governor of a particular province, okay? Or he's even a أَمِيرَةُ قَبِيلَةً, or he's a leader of a tribe, وَمَا أَشْبَهَ ذَلِكَ, and anything other than that. Whether his leadership is big and he's actually the president of the country or the prime minister of the country, or whether he's just a small governor of a province or a borough, it doesn't matter. It's all of that. وَقَدْ أَخْطَأَ, Ibn Uthaymeen, he said he has done wrong, the individual. مَنْ ظَنَّ أَنَّ قَوْلَهُ, that the statement of the Prophet, وَإِنْ تَأَمَّرَ عَبْدٌ عَلَيْكُمْ عَبْدٌ حَبَشِي, he has wronged the person who thought that the statement of the Prophet that if Abyssinian slaves governs you and is controlling your affairs, and al murada bihim al umara alladhina dun al wali al a'lam, is wrong. The person who thinks that this is only referring to what? It's only referring to the umara, whether they are little leaders, small ones. It's not referring to the big president or prime minister. If that's the big president, no, we don't listen to him. If he's the big president. But if he's a province or anything, then we listen. So they specified it on that. You see, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen says that. He also says in his kitab, in his Riyadh al-Salihin, he says, فَلَوْ فُرِضَ أَنَّ السُّلْطَانَ غَلَّبَ النَّاسَ وَاسْتَوْلَى وَسَيْطَرَ وَلَيْسَ مِنَ الْعَرَبِي بَلْ كَانَ عَبْدًا حَبَشِيًّا فَعَلَيْنَا أَنْ نَسْمَعَ وَنُطِيعَ. He says, if it happens that a leader comes over us with force and he takes over our affairs and matters come into his hand, and he is not from the Arabs, he's not an Arab, he's an Abyssinian slave, he said, فَعَلَيْنَا أَنْ نَسْمَعَ وَنُطِيعَ. We have to listen and obey. This matter that I want you to all understand, which is, if it's found a person who is lower in virtue is in power, and we find a person who's more greater in virtue and nobility, we are not entitled, nor are we allowed to say, okay, we have fadil and we have mafdul. This guy's father is greater in virtue and this one is lesser, so we're going to change. We don't do that. We're not allowed to do that. ولذلك الإمام الغزالي رحمه الله he pointed something out. He said, فلا يهدم أصل المصلحة سغفا بمزاياها كالذي يبني قصرا ويهدم مصرا. He said, you are not allowed to destroy a أصل مصلحة, which is original. And the reason is because شغفا, desire and want that you have for what? بمزاياه, you're trying to attain something greater. Okay, we have a leader who is fasiq, he's jahil, he is what? He's zalim, he's an oppressor. And we have a person who's good at leadership, who knows what he's doing, and we have him here and he's virtuous. We are not allowed to get rid of the harm, or or even if he's virtuous, he's good, he's a good person. But if we have a better person, we're not allowed to exchange it for them. And this is something that happened at the time of the Salaf, right? The Sahabas were alive and people in less degree were being given leadership. There's a fadil here. Sahaba are alive. Yazid ibn Muawi, when he was taken, some Sahabas were alive. Sahih? And no doubt the companions are more virtuous and more honorable than he is. So ponder on that. And brothers, this issue goes back to, we're speaking about, is min al-qawa'id al-muqarrarati fi al-shari'ah. It goes back to the principles that the sharia always points out, which is two principles. دَرْءُ الْمَفَاسِدِ مُقَدَّمٌ عَلَى جَلْبِ الْمَصَالِحِ. Repelling the harm takes precedence over bringing any good. He's an Abyssinian slave. Getting rid of this harm, which is that the harm that will come from him being told you have to leave, the harm that will come is given more precedence. We need to bring about the good that you're saying you're going to bring. Oh, am I going to bring something good into the chair? We're going to say to you, first of repelling the harm, it takes precedence. Also, the scholars say that the second qa'ida is لا يجوز إزالة الشر بما هو أشر منه. It is not permissible to remove evil with a greater evil. It's evil that he's gone against the Prophet's command, and that he's not a person who meets the criteria. لكن you're not allowed to remove a evil with a greater evil. And Al-Imam ibn al-Qayyim expanded on this qa'ida in his kitab إعلام الموقعين, third volume, page 12. And if you go against the leader who doesn't meet the criteria that we mentioned, he doesn't meet the basic conditions of a leader, trying to go against him will bring about safkud dima, blood spilling, wa idhalil lil fitan, trials and tribulations will become apparent, wa idha'ati lil amni, the safety will go, wa ta'til lil hudud, and Allah's rulings will also fully be dismantled. فَهُوَ مِنْ إِزَالَةِ الشَّرِّ بِأَشَرِّ مِنْهُ. So it falls under removing evil with a greater evil. The second shubha that they bring forward is طَعْنُهُمْ فِي بَيْعَةِ مَنْ أَخَذَ الْحُكْمَ بِالْقُوَّةِ. They slander and they criticize the one who came into power with what? Force. They say, this guy, he wasn't given bay'ah, he came forcefully. The Ahlul Hall wal Aqd didn't choose him. He came into power with force, so we're not going to accept him. Again, brothers and sisters, the response to this and the refutation and the debunking of this doubt is Al-aslu fi tawalli al-hukm. As we said before, the original, the correct way in which leadership is brought about is either through bishura, shura, which is that he consults and he speaks to the people of Ahlul Hal wal Aqd, or bil-istikhlaf. Al-istikhlaf means the previous leader who will appoint the leader after him, like Abu Bakr did to Umar. Are we all together? Those are two ways which Islamically is correct for the leadership to be brought. But if he doesn't do that path, he doesn't do it that way. Are we all together? He doesn't. And he comes and he takes over forcefully. But the matter of the country is upright for him, meaning it's all done for him now. It's in his hand. There's no way out of it. وَاسْتَقَامَ لَهُ الْأَمْرُ. The matters are in his hand. وَجَبَ طَاعَتُهُ. You have to obey him. وَحُرِمَتْ مُنَازَعَتُهُ. And opposing him is prohibited. And that it is Amr which is مُجْمَعٌ عَلَيْهِ عِنْدَ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَاعَةِ لَا يَخْتَلِفُونَ فِيهِ. أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ unanimously agree upon with each other in this particular issue. And I already brought a consensus. Who did I transmit the consensus from? I transmitted the consensus from three scholars. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, and Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, and Abdul Latif ibn AbdulRahman ibn Hassan rahimahumullahu jami'an. May Allah bestow his never-ending mercy on each and every one of them. That you're not allowed to go against him. So that shubha, it goes against the ijma' of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. The third shubha that we're going to do for today, inshaAllah ta'ala, is dhannuhum. Them believing أن طاعة لا تجب إلا على من بايع بنفسه. They say, I didn't go and give him pledge of allegiance myself. I wasn't there when they chose him. Others have chosen him, and I was not there. So the pledge of allegiance, since it didn't occur from me, since I didn't give him bay'ah, since I did not give him bay'ah, I don't have to obey him. I don't have to listen to him. The response to this, inshaAllah ta'ala, is from three angles. The first angle, al-wajhu al-awwal, is as madama qad bay'a ahlul hal wal aqd. Since the ahlul hal wal aqd, they gave him pledge of allegiance. Fata'at, obedience, and bay'a is obligatory on every single body to occur from them. Even if you did not what? وَإِلَّمْ يُبَايَعُوا يَتَعَهَدْ لَهُمْ بِذَٰلِكَ بِنَفْسِهِ. Even if you did not personally go and give pledge of allegiance to him. As long as the Ahlul Hall wal Aqd have done the bay'ah with him. Ahlul Hall wal Aqd are who? The scholars, the people who have power and strength, the tribal leaders. They are Ahlul Hall wal Aqd. Since they gave the pledge of allegiance, they are speaking on your behalf. Your tribe, they represent you. The scholars, they represent us. The people who have ability in the country, they have influence, they're called Ahlul Hall wal Aqd. Since they have given the pledge of allegiance, then everybody has to be in line with that. The second refutation to them is that the Sahabas and those who came after them, the students of the companions, they were like that. They were like that. They were like what? A group of people will give them a pledge of allegiance. Not every single person will come and give them a pledge of allegiance. إِذْ لَمْ يَشْتَرِطْ أَحَدْ مِنْهُمْ. Not one of the Sahabas conditioned that for the bay'ah to be upon everybody, that every single person has to come and what? He personally has to give the pledge of allegiance in order for him to obey and listen. The third is أن في اشتراط هذا, conditioning this is from the من المشقة والمفسدة. It brings about hardship, and it also brings about corruption. That which any person who's rational and intellectual, let alone a scholar, فضلا عن العالم, let alone a scholar, would not even think of saying, or would realize. How is it? If we say that every single body in the country has to give him a pledge of allegiance, then the hardship that will come from it is he would have to spend every single day opening the door of his palace, letting people coming every day. And his term may even finish, and he hasn't fully what? He hasn't fully been given pledge of allegiance by everybody. And if his land increases, his leadership becomes more, he would then have to go to that country for to get the pledge of allegiance from the people. And everybody of that country has to come to him, or he has to go to them to give them pledge of allegiance. So is he going to spend the rest of his time waiting to take bay'ah from the people, or is he meant to run the country? The mashaqqa that comes from it, the mafsada that comes from it, is every single person, kullu man bayyata su'an, anyone who has in his heart any evil intention and wants to bring about corruption and wants to do division and dispute in the Muslims, this is the proof that he would use. I wasn't there, I didn't get pledge of allegiance. And he would divide the ummah, and then he would bring about corruption. And how would you know that he get pledge of allegiance? The mafsada he would use. The mafsada he would bring about, sorry. And the disunity that he would bring about. Statements of the scholars regarding this particular issue. Shaykh al-Islam, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, 9th volume, page 35, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah said, وَمَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ, whatever Allah has commanded, مِنْ طَاعَةِ وُلَاتِ الْأُمُورِ, in obeying the Muslim leaders, وَمُنَاصَحَتُمْ, and advising them. So whatever Allah has ordered us in regards to listening to the leaders and obeying them and advising them, wajibun ala al-insan, it's obligatory on everybody. Wa illam yu'ahidhum alayhi, even if you are not the one who did the pledge of allegiance with him. Wa illam yahlif lahum al-ayman al-mu'akkada, even if you did not make with them a man which is mu'akkada, oaths and vows and promises, you didn't give that to him. You weren't even there. You never gave any of that to him. كَمَا يَجِبُ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَوَاتُ الْخَمْسِ, just the same way that the 5 daily prayers is obligatory on you, and zakat is obligatory on you, and fasting is obligatory on you, and going to the hajj is obligatory on you, وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكَ, and other things are obligatory on you, مِمَّا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ وَرَسُولُ مِنَ الطَّاعَةِ, the same way is the obeying of the leader, the same way you have to obey Allah and His Messenger, you have to obey the leader. The same way you have to pray, you have to obey the leader. The same way you are commanded to give the zakat, you have to obey the leader. The same way that you are told to come with hajj, you have to also obey the leader. It's wajibat. Al-Allama Muhammad Ali Shawkani rahimahullah, in his kitab Sayyid al-Jarar, he mentioned the 4th volume, page 513. He says, وَلَيْسَ بِشَرْطِ ثُبُوتِ الْإِمَامَةِ أَنْ يُبَايَعَهُ كُلُّ مَنْ يَصْلُحُ لِلْمُبَايَعَةِ ولا من شرط الطاعة على الرجل أن يكون من جملة المبايعين فإن هذا الاشتراط في الأمرين مردود بإجماع المسلمين أولهم وآخرهم سابقهم ولاحقهم. He says, العلامة الشوكاني, he says, وليس من شرط ثبوت الإمامة, it is not from the condition of the establishment of leadership for an individual, أن يبايعه كل من يصلح للمبايعة, that every single person has to go and give him bay'ah and a pledge of allegiance. وَلَا مِنْ شَرْطِ الطَّاعَةِ عَلَى الرَّجُلِ أَنْ يَكُونَ مِنْ جُمْلَةِ الْمُبَايِعِينَ, and it is also not from the condition of obedience to the leader that every single individual has to be from those who came and gave a pledge of allegiance to him. فَإِنَّ هَذَا الْإِشْتِرَاطِ, because that condition that everybody has to give pledge of allegiance is مَرْدُودٌ, is rejected. With what? بِإِجْمَاعِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, by the consensus of the Muslims. أَوَّلُهُمْ وَآخِرُهُمْ, the first of them and the last of them. Sahabas till their day, to this day, no one has said that except those who have deviated from the straight path. سَابِقُهُمْ وَلَاحِقُهُمْ, the early generation and the late generation said it. وَلَكِنَ التَّحَكُّمُ فِي مَسَائِلِ الدِّينِ وَإِيقَاعِهَا عَلَى مَا يُطَابِقُ الرَّأْيَ الْبَيِّنِ الْمَبْنِي, sorry, عَلَى غَيْرِ أَسَاسٍ يَفْعَلُ مِثْلَ هَذَا. And he said something very powerful, Shawkani. He said, but forcing your personal opinions on matters of the religion, these are the, and it's based on no principles, based on no foundation. This is the kind of outcomes that it brings. This is the kind of results that it brings. That person will just speak with no knowledge. He'll place statements like that which he has no knowledge on. وَإِذَا تَقَرَّ لَكَ مَا ذَكَرْنَاهُ, Shawkani says, if what we have mentioned to you has become established for you, now it's become clear to you, فَهَذَا الَّذِي قَدْ بَايَعَهُ أَهْلُ الْحَلِّ, this person, أَهْلُ الْحَلِّ وَالْعَقْدُ, has chosen him. قَدْ وَجَبَتْ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِ الْقُطْرِ The people of that land, it's obligatory on them. الَّذِي تَنْفُذُ فِي أَوَامِرُهُ The place where his commands are executed. When he speaks, he's got army there. Are we all together? It's upon the people of that land, since his statements are followed by his army and his... Then it's upon you to hear and obey him. طَاعَتُ And he said, this is based on what? بِالْأَدِلَّةِ الْمُتَوَاتِرَةِ It's based upon the multitude narration that we have in this regard. Al-Imam Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he said a statement like that in his liqa' bi Abil Maftuha. He also said the same in his Sharh Riyad al-Salihin. The same was said by Al-Qurtubi, Al-Imam Al-Munawi, Abdul Ra'uf Al-Munawi, Al-Imraniyu rahimahullah, Al-Imam Al-Imraniyu Al-Shafi'i, he said the same. Also Ibn Al-Muqri Al-Shafi'i, Ibn al-Muqri al-Shafi'i, he also said the same. Those six scholars that I mentioned, all stated that not everybody has to give bay'ah. Not every single person has to what? Give a pledge of allegiance. So inshallah ta'ala, we will stop there inshallah ta'ala for today. We'll stop there today inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.